والمؤمنات والمسلمين والمسلمات الأحياء منهم والأموات إنك قريب الدعوات.
In Nambunju, a small village in eastern Tanzania, 6 out of 10 people carry the malaria virus. Most are women and children. Sofia, a young mother, is worried about her baby daughter, Farida. She has a high fever.
Hodi, Sofia. Tumefika kukuona tena bana. Eh? Leo unajua mtoto ajambo.
I went to Sofia's house. I assessed the baby. The problem I see today is Sofia not using a mosquito bed net and the child is always fall sick. I advised the mother to send the child to the dispensary.
Kwa bora umpeleke kesho hospitali ajili ya vipimo.
Mrudishe hospitali kwa ajili ya vipimo zaidi kwa sababu huyu damu yake inaonekana imeshuka.
The big killer of the children in Nambunju is malaria.
Ete nione meno.
We raise awareness of the community by educating them to know to recognize the early signs and symptoms of malaria.
Choni kuangalia nani? Nancy.
Malaria is caused by the Anopheles mosquito, which spreads the virus by sucking the blood of an infected human and passing it to its next victim. That is why a physical barrier, such as a bed net, is crucial in preventing the disease. This year, nearly 250 million people around the world will be infected by malaria. More than 800,000 people will die.
There are 80,000 malaria deaths in the country, but malaria is a treatable disease. The challenge is we want to reduce those deaths by half.
The only way to diagnose the illness is from a blood test. But testing is difficult and expensive, and many villages are not equipped for the work. Government clinics like this one carry out tens of thousands of blood tests each year.
My name is Nahia Salim. I'm working with Ifakara Health Institute, Bagamoyo branch, as a pediatrician. More than half of the beds are occupied with malaria cases. And we see anemia and convulsions as common complications associated with malaria. When I arrived in the ward, we had two serious patients. One of them, he was admitted with a fever and a history of convulsion. So we had to start treatment as a case of severe malaria. So sometimes when the child starts to have convulsions, they usually go to the traditional healers, receive some local treatments, and that complicates the whole situation. We have a huge task to do, to change the perception of the community.
I went to Sofia's house to make a follow-up so that to know if the child is doing better or not. The child was sick with a high fever. During my assessment, I found a child with a bracelet, and this indicated that they go to the traditional healers. They believe that when you put on that bracelet, this kind of helps prevent them or their children from becoming sick, especially having convulsions. And we are trying to educate that the convulsion itself is due to a fever and nothing else.
Ali decides to reach out to the traditional healer, Mr. Hamidi Mohammed.
Karibu
bwana. Sawa. Shikamo.
Marhaba.
Habari za hapa?
Alhamdulillah.
Before dispensary, the parents used to go to the traditional healers. Now we educate our traditional healers to work together with the dispensary or health center. Because we need them to help us to educate people. We trained them to assess the children, and if the problem is malaria, they normally ask them to go to the dispensary or hospital. Me as a medical personnel and the community try to solve the problem together.
The Ifakara Health Institute is well known for carrying out research on the effectiveness of bed nets, developing new drugs, and carrying out clinical trials on a malaria vaccine. The IHI is part of the worldwide effort by governments and non-government organizations to tackle the disease.
For the last 10 years, I've been involved in doing malaria research work. The last piece of work that we have done is on testing new vaccines. And so far, we have tested the RTSS, which is the most advanced malaria vaccine to date. We have to really focus on prevention, because the time between somebody getting an illness and succumbing to the illness may be very short. And with everything that we have today, we cannot prevent that death.
No amount of medicine will help the village if people don't know the basic facts about malaria.
We have a community health plan in Rufiji to fight against malaria. We educate our community to keep their environment clean and also to use treated bed nets.
In these remote areas, there is no radio or television, and getting the message out can be a challenge. A local drama group is hired to help the community recognize the symptoms of the disease and convince them to bring their sick to the medical clinic rather than the traditional healer. Even the men, often the household decision makers, turn up to watch the show.
We should empower people to understand what malaria is and what they can do. I have seen a lot of reductions in malaria because of the interventions that we've been doing. However, it is tricky to eradicate malaria. It is tricky because malaria knows no borders. We have to work together. We have to be persistent until we see the last case of malaria gone.
Farida Rajabu. Farida. Amelala.
Sofia's baby was diagnosed to have malaria and got anti-malaria medicine from the dispensary.
Kama utaona kuna tatizo lolote mlete mtoto tumuone. Sawa bwana?
I show Sofia how to put on bed net. Then herself did the same.
Ukiingia unaingizia. Kwa hiyo huku juu kumekaa vizuri.
Ndio.
Okay, kwa hiyo hapa akishaingia kulala anaingizia tu.
Now Sofia is using bed net. And I expect the baby, if we continue to sleep in a bed net, this will be one method of preventing malaria.
Very difficult. Unfortunately, the child developed convulsions this morning, having continuous convulsions with fever. So we had to start treatment for cerebral malaria as the disease continued to progress. And we see the child was not responding well. We are really struggling to improve, and we're not going to stop. Hopefully it will work.